गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। इज वॉइस ऑडिबल? इज वॉइस इज ऑडिबल? काइंडली रिप्लाई हियर। Are you able to see the screen? Okay, so kindly mark your attendance using three parameters. Okay, so this is the video lecture. We are going to have on design and analysis of algorithms. We are currently discussing with our last topic, that is module 1, introduction of algorithms. We have gone with all the 6 topics. The last one we are going to see is fundamental data structures. So what is the fundamental data structure? So this one you have already studied. So you have studied all these concepts in a previous semester data structure. Okay. So can anybody define what is DS? Define, you have written the exam and all, define data structure. So kindly answer in the chat box. So in today's class, we'll be discussing with new concepts, that is fundamental data structures. So anybody can answer in the chat box the definition of DS. So what do you mean by DS? Answer. So data structure means, you have written in the exam, then tell me what is data structure. Anybody else? What is data structure? No one? Okay, I will tell you. Data is considered any program. So data, you are going to sort it according to one particular format. So that one we call it as structuring of data. That is data structure. Okay, so data structure is nothing but organizing the data or storing the data. That is called as a data structure. So organizing the data, we call it as data structure here. Okay. So which are the types of data structure we have? So we have gone with the types of data structures. So many concepts we have discussed in the third sem, DS only. So data structure is the way of organizing the data. What is the data structure? It is the way of organizing the data is called what? Data structure. So that one we call it as DS. The organizing the data, we call it as DS. So now we shall go with the fundamental data structures. So all these data structures, you are familiar with all these things. So which are the, there are two types of data structure. One is linear data structure. The other one is non-linear data structure. Okay. So coming for the linear data structures. So which are the linear data structures we have? So one is arrays, stack, queue, linked list. So all these will come under linear data structure. So non-linear, we get that in non-linear, we get trees and graphs. Okay. So which are the linear data structure? So first we shall go with array. So array is a, what is the define array? Anybody else? Define an array. Answer here. So no problem. If you are chatting related to your subject, you can chat it here. So tell me, what is an array? Collection of homogeneous elements. Collection of homogeneous elements, we call it as array. Okay, so what is the data is stored in sequential order. Okay, so that means a group of elements, the group of elements of same data type. Homogeneous means same. Group of elements of same data type, we call it as array. So inside the array, you can place n number of elements. So that one will be starting with array index 0 up to index something. This is the array length. Array length is how much? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So totally, what is the length of the array? It is 5. So it will start at 0th location and it will end at 4th location. So now we have placed the element at index 3. So this one we call it as an array. Okay. So now after the array, now you come for the linked list. Okay. So under linked list, what are all the things you will be having? So linked list, singly linked list. The other one is doubly linked list. So how many fields we have in singly linked list? So can anybody can tell how many fields in singly linked list? How many fields you'll be having? Two fields. So two fields in singly linked list, which are those? Name the two fields. Anybody else? Only one is replying. Kindly reply later. You can chat regarding your subject. So you have, they are telling in singly linked list, you have two fields. So one is in two fields. One is the info field, that is data field. The other one is the next field. Okay, good. So next field, it contains the address of the next list. Okay. So what the two fields? One is the info field or called as the data field. The other one is the next field or the address field, which contains the address of the next block. So here is the representation we have taken here. So this is singly linked list. So under singly linked list, we have two fields. Well, this one is data field, that is information field. The other one is the address field called next pointer. Next pointer will contain the address of the next block. So what is the next block? We have 7. 7, where the 7 is there, that particular address is being stored in next pointer. Okay, so it is stored in next pointer here. Okay, so come for the doubly linked list. So doubly linked list, how many fields? So doubly linked list. How many fields you are having? You are having three fields. Okay. So first one you go with a three fields. Here we have one is the this one is called previous pointer. This one is called data, and this one is called next pointer. What is the difference we have in single linked list and the doubly linked list? Here we have two fields. Here we have three fields. So here there is info, data, and next pointer. Here we have data, next pointer, and previous pointer. So three, what the previous pointer will point? So previous pointer will point to the previous node. It contains, so next pointer will contain, next pointer will contain the address of next node. So previous pointer will contain the address of previous node. So that is the concept we have here. So this is doubly linked list we have gone through. Now, apart from that, now you have another two types. So which are the two types we have? One is stack, the other one is queue. So and next you go with a stack here. So coming for stack. So stack is LIFO or FIFO? So stack is LIFO or FIFO? Stack is LIFO, correct? So what is stack? So is it correct? You have put it as LIFO, last in, first out. So is it correct? Anybody can answer. Okay, it is LIFO. That means here you go with this particular thing. So first you have empty stack. So insertion and deletion both can be done at same end. So that's why you push the element. What are the stack operations we have? So which are the stack operations? So stack operations are push and pop. Okay, good. So push means placing the elements into the stack, and pop means deleting the element from the stack. So to come for this particular example here, so first you have empty stack. Okay, so what is the condition for empty stack? So what is the condition for empty stack? What we call when the stack is empty, what is the condition we call? So, okay, good. You are correct. So it is also called as underflow condition. So underflow means, so when there is no elements, so we are going to have it like this. So underflow. When top is not containing any element, we call it as underflow. Okay, good. So now when you keep on pushing, push the element, one will come. Again, you are pushing the element. See the operation, it is push operation. Again, you have value two. Okay, now after that, so last inserted, if you want to pop the element, so last inserted will be the first to be out. So that's why we call stack as last to be in is the first to be out. So keep this one is the stack operation. Okay. So what if when you call the stack full condition? So give the answer for stack full condition. What we call it as stack full? So when it is stack full, we call it as overflow. Okay. Overflow will happen when top is equal to max. If top is equal to max, so you will be having overflow condition. Okay, so that is the stack operation we have seen. Now you come for the next one, that is queue. So what happens inside the queue? So queue is a type of data structure where insertion will happen at one end and deletion will happen at another end. So insertion will happen at one end and deletion will happen at another end. So insertion will happen at which end? Can you tell in queue? I'm not taking any example, just you take. So insertion will be done at rear end and deletion will be done at where the deletion will be done. Okay, good. So deletion will be done at front end. So come for this particular example. So here, if you are inserting an element, so see here, if you are inserting an element, we call it as NQ. ENQ, that is NQ. Inserting an element at rear end, we call it as NQ. And deleting the element at the front end, we call it as BQ. Okay, so here we have taken a simple queue. It's not circular queue or whatever you have. So here we have taken only the simple queue. So simple queue, the insertion will happen at the rear end and deletion will happen at the front end. So at that time, we call it as queue operation. So, okay. So can you tell when the queue is full with front end rear parameters? Can you tell when the queue is full? When the queue is full? Give the condition for that. So when the queue is full, give the condition. When you tell the queue is full, what will be the condition for queue full? No answer. When you tell the queue is full, no overflow. Overflow will only come in stack only. So here you tell it as queue full or queue empty. Okay, no overflow and underflow in queues. Okay, I'm asking you what is the condition. So you have told top is equal to minus one, that is a condition for empty. So top double equals max, so that is the condition for full, stack full. So what is the condition for queue full? So when you tell it as queue full, okay, so when front is equal to rear plus one, so you can easily write it as rear is equal to, so max. So suppose if you take it as max, max means queue of elements. So if rear double equals max or max plus one, so that is the condition for queue full. So what queue empty? What is the condition for queue empty? When we tell it as queue empty, okay, so when there is no elements, so if the elements are there, what will happen? So the front end will go somewhere, rear end will be somewhere. So if your entire stack is, entire queue is empty, where the front end rear will be? So front end rear will point to same location. So keep in your mind, front and rear will point to same location when the queue is empty. So at that time, we take it as front double equals rear or front equals rear equals minus one. Both are correct. So Sharath Endi and Aishwarya S are put the correct answers here. So good. So it's correct. Okay. So now you come for the next one. So this is the NQ operation. So this one is DQ operation. So NQ means inserting the element at the rear end, we call it as NQ, and deleting the element at the front end, we call it as DQ. So this is the fundamental data structure, linear data structure we have seen. So can you name which are the linear data structures? name, which are the linear data structures we have, we are having. Can you name some? Array, stack, queues, linked list. So everything will come under? Okay, good. It is linear data structure. Okay, now you come for the non-linear data structure. So now you are getting into non-linear. This is very much important from exam point. So all the non-linear data structure, we have trees and graphs. Okay, so trees and graphs. Okay, so now you go with that graphs first. So inside the graph, so what the graph will contain? So graph will contain two parameters. So can you name what the graph will contain? The graph will contain two parameters. So can you tell what is G is equal to? Okay, so G is equal to V comma E. That is V is vertices and E is edges. Okay, V comma E. Okay, good. So inside that, so now you come for the types of graph. So under types of graph, you have two types. One is undirected graph. The other one is directed graph. So directed and undirected. So how many in this particular diagram? This is undirected graph. There is no direction from any of the nodes. So this one we call it as undirected because there are no directions in any of this particular graphs. So how many vertices are there? There are 6 vertices. So which are those? A, B, C, D, E, F. And how many edges you are having? So edge is nothing but two vertices connecting through a line. Two vertices connecting through a line. We call it as edge. So how many edges we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's why if there are six vertices, how many edges you can have? You can have vertices plus edges plus 1. So what is edges is equal to vertices plus 1. So that will be the minimum condition for the vertices and edges. Okay. So if there is no directions, we call it as undirected graph. If there is direction, we call it as directed graph. So directed graph means you are having the directions from one node to one vertex to another vertex. So from A to C. So if there is undirected means, if there is undirected graph from A to C, there are two things. One is from A to C is also there, C to A is also there. So come for this path, A to D. So path A to D is also there, D to A is also there. But when you come for directed graph, so only if there it is A to C, only A to C is there, C to A is not there. So that is the undirected means it will go with two directions. Directed means only one direction. Okay. So are you people understanding? Are you people understanding? Okay. So now we have gone with undirected, directed. Now you come for the weighted graph. Okay. So weighted means, so from one edge to another edge. So directed weighted graph, so there will be the some weights will be given on the edges. So that's when we call it as weighted graph. So under weighted graph, we have some weights representing on the edges. Okay, so next you come for the next parameter, cycle. So when you tell it as a cycle, so when you are moving from starting with one and moving with another. So here you can see there is a path from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 4 to 0. So keep this one in your mind. This is called cycle. So where you're starting at the same end and ending with same vertex. So starting with same vertex and ending with same vertex, we call it as cycle. So what is the path? 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 4 to 0. That one we call it as cycle. Okay. So now come for the graphical representation. So if there is a graph, now you have to go with the representation. So this one we have already seen adjacency matrix and adjacency list. So adjacency matrix and adjacency list. So you have to take the example of this one or this. So let's see. So there is a path. So adjacency, how to write the adjacency matrix and adjacency list, we shall see in this particular thing. So if one will represent, there is a path, and zero will represent, there is no path. So from, there is a path from A to C, and there is a path from A to D. So keep this one in your mind. So there is a path from A to C, and there is a path from A to D. So this one, the, I think this is the diagram they have taken. Okay, so from A to C as well as A to D. Okay, that's why we have written A to C and A to D. Now from B to C and B to F. So B to C and B to F. So for this part, this diagram only they have written. So you can see here adjacency matrix and adjacency list. So come for C part, C to A, C to B, C to E. C to A, C to B, and C to E. Come for D. So D to A, D to E. Come for E. D to, E to D, E to F, E to C. Come for F. E to F to B, F to E. So that is the finally for F, it will be F to B and F to E. So this is the adjacency matrix. Adjacency matrix you are having. Now you come for the adjacency list. So a list means, so path from source. So if you are starting with A to C and A to D. So that one we are reading it as A to C. And again, it is not C to D. It is A to D we are representing like this. So from A to C and A to D. So A, C, D. From B to C and B to F. So that's why we written B to C and F. Come for C, A, B, E, A, B, E. Come for D, A, E. So from D you are going for A and E. Come for E, it is for C, D, F. So write the using the arrow marks. Finally F you have for B as well as E. So this is the adjacency matrix and adjacency list for your which graph? This is the graph we have taken, and for that we have written matrix and list. Okay. So now you come for this. How you write the adjacency matrix, and list for the weighted graph? So this one, no weights. Now you come for this particular thing. How to write? So this is the weighted graph. So under weighted graph, so from A to B, what is the weight? 5. From A to C, this is the directed or undirected graph. Can anybody can tell? So this particular diagram, whether it is directed or undirected. Okay, good. It is undirected graph. That means there is, you have to tell there is a path from A to B as well as B to A. Okay, good. So come for this representation. How many vertices you are there? Write the ABCD, ABCD. Is there any path from A to A? To A? No path. Write infinity. A to B, path is there. Okay. So A to B, path is there. Write it as 5. A to C, path is there. Write it as 1. A to D, no path, infinity. Come for B. So B to A, path 5. And B to C, path 7. B to D, path 4. Okay, come for C. So C to A, 1. C to B, 7. C to C, not there. C to D, 2. Come for D. So D to B is 4. D to C is 2. So that you will be writing. Okay, so this is adjacency matrix for the weighted graph. So adjacency list. So that you should write it as A to B and A to C. From A, you are having B and C. So write it as B with weight. What is the weight from A to B? It is 5. So that's why we are writing it as B, 5, C, 1. From B, A, 5, C, 7, D, 4. From C, A, 1, B, 7, D, 2. Then finally for D, you have B, 4, C, 2. This is adjacency matrix, adjacency list for the weighted graph. Okay. So that is up to graphs. So are you people getting right? How to write adjacency matrix and adjacency list? So understood adjacency matrix and adjacency list? Okay. That we have finished with which non-linear data structure? That is graphs. So under graphs, you go with underrated, underrated, weighted graph and cycle. Okay. So come for the trees and forests now. So graph is the one non-linear data structure. Apart from that, you have trees and forest. Okay. So what is tree that we shall see it here? So trees comma forest, you will be having like this. So this is a tree they have taken. So tree, we have given it as A to B, A to C, C to D, and C to G, and F to G. So this is a tree. Come for forest. So can anybody name what in define forest? This is one of the tree terminologies. So when you tell it as forest, so when you tell it as forest, so you will be telling it as group of trees. So just a general thing. If there is only one tree, it doesn't mean it is forest. But when you go for forest, how many trees you will be having? You will be having group of trees. So group of trees, we call it as forest. This one is a tree. This one is a forest. So see here, this is one tree. So how many trees we have in this particular diagram? Can you tell? How many trees we have in this particular B diagram B? So in diagram B, it is a forest. Okay, how many trees we have? How come three trees? So it is two. You are having two. So the A, B, C, D, E, F, G. This is one tree. The other one is H, I, J. This is the another tree. Two trees are there in this particular diagram. Okay. So now you see here, this is the tree and its transformed tree we are taking like this. Okay. So A. So from A, what is the path you are having? From A, you start with A, okay? For this tree, they have written this particular tree, okay? From A, you are having path to B, D, E. So from A, you write it to B, D, E. Come for B here. From B, you are having path to C and G. So from B, write it to C and G. So from C, you are having to H and I. So from C, H and I. So D is not there, G also not there. Come for E. For E, you will be writing it as F. This is the free tree and it is the transformation into rooted tree. Okay. So that is up to trees concept. So for that, now you have to represent using list. Okay. So take this particular thing and represent. Okay. So how you will be writing this particular thing, we shall see. So we have gone with this particular diagram. So take this particular. So how you will be writing from A, you are having link to B. From B, you are having link to C. So from B, you have to C. So from where you are going to have? from B, you are arriving to C and D. So B to C, B to D. From C, you are arriving to H and G. So H is here, G is here. Okay, from finally you come for D to E and E to F. So this is the link list representation. So it is the list representation of a binary tree. For the graph also, we have gone with adjacency matrix, adjacency list. So for the tree also, we should go with matrix. No matrix will there, but you can represent using list. Okay. Okay, understood up to here? Okay, so now you come for the binary, another concepts under tree and forest. So it is an ordered tree. Under ordered tree, you have two concepts. One is binary tree, binary search tree. Okay, so when define binary tree? So define binary tree. So when you tell it is a tree, is a binary tree. So when you tell it as a binary tree, is a binary tree? If it has as minimum of two children. So here, this is the root. So this is binary tree and this is binary search tree. So binary tree, here you are having two children. For this also, you are having two children, but here it is one and one. Okay. So it is called almost complete binary tree. Okay, so almost complete means if the leaf node is having less number of nodes than previous one, it is called almost complete binary tree. So this is binary search tree. So a tree is called binary search tree if the left child is less than root and right child is greater than root. So take this particular same diagram. So just they have inserted 9, left child is 5, which is less. And right child is 12. So come for 5, left child is 1, right is 7. For 12, left child is 10. So this is the binary tree. Okay. So after the binary tree, now you come for list representation. So how to represent the binary tree? So take this particular diagram. So here we have taken tree representation using list. So write the tree. So left child and right child will remain. So left child will point to 5. So that's why left child, we are having the array to 5. And right child, we are having a link to 12. Okay. From 5, you go with 1 and 7. Okay. From 5, you go with 1 and 7. Next, from 12, you will point it to 10. So similarly, from 1, you will write it, you will be having for 4. Okay, so this is the list representation of a binary tree. So in the previous, we have gone with this is also list representation of a tree. And this one, we call it as a list representation of a binary tree. Okay, so understood up to here? Okay, so all these particular things, we have kindly go through using the slides we have given in the Google Classroom. I've uploaded the notes also there. Kindly read the notes. Okay, so here I will be ending this particular session. So thank you all.